There are actually two diseases that fall under the umbrella of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which we just call COPD as an acronym. The first one of these is emphysema. And this is a disease that has to do with airway collapse due to change in the structure of the walls. What I'm going to talk about today is the other category called chronic bronchitis. Chronic bronchitis. Now, both of these are obstructive, meaning air is stuck in the lungs and it can't get out. But in our case, in chronic bronchitis, the culprit here is too much mucus. So that's going to be the theme of the day. Remember that, too much mucus. Just a quick Latin lesson here. So chronic, over a long, long period of time, bronch refers to the lungs. And anytime you see itis in a medical context, it means inflammation of that area. So we have constant irritation of the lungs. Speaking of which, let's draw some lungs. So we have the trachea here, branching off into the left and right main bronchi. And it just keeps branching off into smaller and smaller segments. That's the basic pattern in the organization of the lungs. I can't draw all the levels here. Just wanted to give you an idea. They go like that. And of course, on this side, it's the same thing. I'm just not going to draw that right now. And keep in mind that along with the lungs, we have the blood supply lying very close to it. And this is where the gas exchange happens, back and forth from the blood into the lungs. And of course, what's going into the lungs is our oxygen. And what's coming back out is carbon dioxide. In a nutshell, that's what the lungs do. So keep in mind this gas exchange. So chronic bronchitis is what happens when the airway becomes all gunky with too much mucus. Now mucus in there is a normal thing. You and I, when we get sick, you cough up the phlegm. That's basically what it is. It's the body's defense mechanism against any irritants that are bothering our lungs. As you can see, when the space gets all gunked up like that, the air going back and forth between the lungs and the blood supply is hard to get across. In addition, it's just going to be hard to move air through. See, the oxygen is getting in here, and the walls just become narrower. It's harder to move through the mush. That's where all the problems come from. So when I talk about irritation, it can come from things like being a smoker. Smoking every day irritates the lungs. Or if you live in a very polluted place, pollution can do that as well. And what goes with that is smog from our cars. Or this person can have an allergy, and the allergens constantly irritating the lungs can lead to this as well. So chronic bronchitis is the lung's response. It does not specify one kind of irritant. So if we have a guy here with chronic bronchitis, I'm going to give him some hair because I just think it makes all my stick figures look a little better. Here we go. He has a big fro. Let's call him Robert or Bob. Give him some eyes. And I'm going to draw his mouth in blue here. It's referring to an infamous nickname that people with chronic bronchitis have. They're called blue bloaters. And you'll see this in every textbook. It's kind of confusing. Why are they blue? So let's break this down one word at a time. Blue is talking about the fact that they're blue as opposed to red. If we come back here to the oxygen, we think of blood with oxygen in it looks a little bit brighter and more red than blood without oxygen. So if the lung's job is to deliver this oxygen to our blood supply, with all this gunk in here, since they get not as much air, not as much oxygen across, this person's going to look a little bit bluish to the tint. And this shows up in the lips, it can show up in the whites of the eyes, it can show up in the person's nail beds, depending on their complexion, sometimes it can show up in their skin. So blue refers to the fact that they have lower oxygen. So instead of having a percentage of oxygen in the high 90s, like people usually do, high 90s to 100, they might have lower 90s, 80s, depending on the severity. And the second word here, bloater, refers to their shape. So if you can imagine, Bob can't take a good breath in, can't get enough oxygen. Then he's going to take bigger and deeper breaths to try to compensate for that, right? Which artificially increases his chest volume. So since this is a chronic disease, then over years and years, the diameter of his chest actually increases. He literally just looks bloated. In addition, we have carbon dioxide back in the lungs here that are trapped. This is when we talked about obstruction in the beginning. So it's obstructed in the lungs and can't get out as effectively. And that further leads to the expansion of his chest diameter. So he's just going to look bloated and kind of hypoxic. Let's write that word again, which just means lower oxygen, not enough oxygenation. So blue bloater is someone with lower oxygen who is literally bloated from trying to get more air in and can't get all the air out. Now the second component they'll have is a very nagging cough. Now this cough is actually part of the diagnosing criteria. So chronic bronchitis is actually diagnosed through the story. So they have to have a cough for 3 months out of the year, for 2 years in a row. This has to be consecutive. And this cough has to be productive. So there has to be mucus, phlegm that they're coughing up. And that pretty much diagnoses chronic bronchitis. So this cough has to be present. And what makes this cough happen is, if we're going to go back to our lungs here, embedded in the green part, I don't know if you can see this, but in the tissue of the walls of the lungs, there is smooth muscle. So in response to all this irritation going on, the smooth muscle spasm, and that's how you get the cough. It's a reflex, we can't help it. It's our body's natural way of getting rid of irritants. And when it goes overboard, we have chronic bronchitis. Now, another component I wanted to mention is that even though chronic bronchitis is a chronic disease, it can have acute flare-ups or acute episodes where it suddenly gets a lot worse. This can happen when our patient has a cold, they can have the flu. By the way, this is why it's important for people with this disease to get flu shots. Or it can just even happen from it being winter and the air being cold, because cold air also irritates the lungs and causing spasm of the airways and can make the cough worse. The acute flares can happen when there's a double whammy to the irritation of the lungs. So the mucus goes even more overboard, and sometimes one section of the lung can be just clogged off, one little branch, because there's so much mucus here. Now, it's a rule in the body that anytime you have complete obstruction like that, the bacteria will build up behind it. Anytime you have bacteria build up, you can have infection. In the lungs, we call this pneumonia. So pneumonia can be bacteria or it can be viral. But in this case, if it's a blockage of this of the mucus, it's very likely to be bacterial. And once you have infection on top of obstruction, it makes it even harder to clear the infection. So now Bob is in real deep trouble. So part of the treatment is to not only prevent acute flares, but to treat them aggressively. So coming back to the beginning, like I said, the theme of our day is mucus production. As you can see, a person with chronic bronchitis will have a nagging cough, they'll be hypoxic with not enough oxygen in their blood, and they'll be bloated from trying to take deep breaths and not being able to breathe out all the extra air.